culture has a set of creeds.
In the United States, black culture and identity has a tendency to be closely tied with religion. This can be seen in black neighborhoods and black-centric media. However, there is a small but growing segment of the black population who do not subscribe to the mainstream tenets of black religiosity. What is it like to not have religion in a society that equates blackness with being a believer?
D.O.U.G.L.E.'s never met a black atheist. I'll never know a faith based on a factual basis. So we're even from Christian to Islamic law. And now they speak enough from Compton to Islamabad.
To get a better understanding, it is necessary to speak with black non-believers. All three, in this case, live and work in Southern California. Rapper Graydon Square, Nicomi Taylor, member of the nonprofit organization Black Skeptics Los Angeles, and lawyer Frederick Sparks. How did these three go from believers to non-believers? Graydon describes a conversation he had with an ex-girlfriend.
For me, it never made sense. You know, the slavery, the rape, the pillage, the indifference, it never made sense to me. It all seemed like just a bad explanation. But I didn't have anything to go on. One day, we get into just the biggest argument we ever had. And it was about slavery. I asked her a question. I said, if our ancestors had not been a product of the transatlantic slave trade, would we, as black Americans, believe in Christianity the way that we do? Okay? She says, yes, because God has a plan. This was his plan. We were his people to be led out of Africa, which is why Africa's so messed up. These were her words. My thing was like, you're crazy. How can you think that this makes sense? So we part our ways that time, and from then on, it was like, man, I gotta know more about this. I mean, you know, the internet's right there. Let me just look. And I started searching, and I found one thing. And it led me to another thing. And it led me to another thing. And by the time I was at number 8, I was like, what the hell am I looking for again? I don't even know what I'm looking for. I just know that I can't stop looking. I never felt like this as a Christian. The desire to continue to learn. No matter what, I would drop dead trying to search for information if I had to. I didn't get that in Christianity. You don't get that in Islam. At a certain point, you get to a door, they say, no, you can't enter this door.
A growing curiosity also played a part in Nicomi's rejection of Christianity.
Well, I started talking, of course, to some of my closest friends about it because I was, you know, learning things that I had never knew before about the universe and cosmos and, you know, things you learn in school but you don't necessarily fully pay attention to or at least try to retain because, you know, you're conflicted with the religious teaching that you have in the church. And I think that was my issue. So I've always wondered about a lot of different things, but I never really took the time to look for the answer and the information. And when I got on this Christian, the super Christian journey is what I like to call it, because I myself believe that I was kind of half-stepping all of my life as a Christian because I didn't always do the things that you know, you're told to do. You know, you have sex out of wedlock and all that good stuff. And I just carried around this guilt for just basically being human.
There were many aspects of Frederick's life that influenced his eventual switch to atheism.
God and what the Bible was really came from maybe two seminal movies. One was, of course, the Ten Commandments. And that's pretty much where people learn about what's in the Old Testament, because, you know, a lot of folks don't read it. And so there was that, and then so that gave me some sort of idea around God. And of course, as a kid, what I really loved were the special effects, you know, the snake and the water dividing. And even as a kid, it bothered me that God didn't act in those ways that were really like public and obvious anymore, because I wanted to see that. I was like, that's cool. I want to see that. And I guess, you know, I don't know if anybody told me this specifically, but, you know, you sort of get this idea that, well, God had to do those things back then, you know, to prove to people that he was real, but now he needs for us to believe on faith. So I, you know, accepted that, but that always sort of got at me. Also being gay and what I went through in terms of acceptance of that because of what the religion's message, as I understood it, was about that. And I knew that this was not something that I was choosing or selecting, and I had prayed to be changed. And when that never happened, you know, that definitely planted a seed in my head to start questioning, I think.
What is presented in the mainstream media is often a reflection of the culture that it is aimed at. Media aimed at African Americans tend to have either religious overtones or religious undertones. Unfortunately, during the few times there have been black atheist characters in black films and television, they are portrayed negatively. Nakomi tells us about the TV One network's family sitcom, Bells, and a scene that shows one of the female cast members discovering her date's secret.
The girl was dating, her father, I guess, was a preacher, and she was dating a black guy who happened to be an atheist, and it got brought up at the dinner table.
Oh, your parents must be very proud.
Oh, yes.
I wouldn't know.
Oh, Aunt Gladys, I think these are the best bourbon mashed potatoes you've ever made.
Well, what do you mean you wouldn't know?
We haven't talked in 10 years.
Are they in some kind of a coma?
We had a falling out.
Well, what kind of falling out?
Over religion.
Yours or theirs?
Both, in fact.
Well, what are they?
They're Baptists.
Well, all right.
And you are?
I'm an atheist.
And it was looked at as a negative.
I'm gonna need another help in those bourbon mashed potatoes.
He basically made a logical argument for why he didn't believe in God.
So you became an atheist when, after seeing some traumatic event covering the war?
Or maybe somebody dropped you on your head when you were a baby or something like that.
I said I'll handle this.
Actually, sir, it was a decision based on science, reason, and logic.
I see.
With all due respect, sir, we just have different philosophies, that's all.
Her argument was that, you know, he should have told her sooner, I guess because she is religious and she had a problem with the fact that he kept his atheism from her.
So it doesn't mean anything that I love you.
How could you love anybody if you don't love God?
Basically, they ended up not dating because, you know, he was an atheist and she wasn't. So I think things like that do not help with the progression of the black community and the overall atheist community in general.
Frederick gives us a few more examples.
So Omar Epps on House, I guess all the doctors on House were atheists, so he was explicitly atheist. Ice Cube's character in Boys in the Hood, they're sitting in the car, they're on the Shaw, you know, sitting in the car, and he's like, fool, there ain't no God. You know, they start having this philosophical discussion.
Do I believe in God?
Yeah, I guess I do. How else can you have a sun, the moon, and the stars and shit like that?
Sun, moon, stars, quasars, motherfuckers sound like Airwood jets. There ain't no God. Okay, there was a God. Why be letting motherfuckers get smoked every night? Babies and little kids, you tell me that.
And so that was one. And then, but back in the day, on Good Times, After John Amos' character was written off, James died. His man, who actually was Michael's boss, and the first, when they introduce him, it's because Michael comes home and says he doesn't believe in God, because this man, Carl, that I work for, doesn't believe in God either.
It's that mumbo-jumbo about one nation under God.
What?
Yeah, Carl says there is no God, and I'm not gonna say there is.
What did you say?
Michael, don't say anything. Tell him a chance to hide. Maybe I get out of the lightning striking place there.
That was the first time I had ever seen any black atheist characters. But for the most part, they're just not there.
Atheists don't really have a place in black media like that.
Historically, black atheists have not fared well in black cinema.
Getting the credit for all the things the human race achieves through its own stubborn effort. Now, there simply is no God. There's only man. And it's he who makes miracles.
And the idea of skipping church is still frowned upon, even in modern film and television.
What did you say?
The Reverend's putting on his Christmas show, Black Nativity.
Well, count me out. I don't do church.
Choose for yourselves this day which God you will serve.
When negative messages about atheism such as this...
My definition of God is humanity and is the love of humanity. And as we return to, you know...
Well, I don't call you an atheist then. I think if you believe in the awe and the wonder and in the mystery, that is what God is.
I don't criticize anybody because you know what? The definition of life is we will never know. Mm-hmm. We will never know, you know, what...
Until that last breath.
Yeah.
And maybe it's an oh wow one for you. You know,
and this.
I mean, but what is an atheist? I don't really get into that. You know, I've talked to people all the time. I'm an atheist. I just walk away. I don't know what to say to you. You know,
well, an atheist is someone who doesn't quite believe that there is somebody out there, some God out there.
Well, then to me, you're an idiot.
Okay.
Are so prevalent, how can they be combated? Frederick believes that media messages can play a role.
Like when we started seeing more gay characters on television, Will and Grace, I think, you know, all the progress that's been made in terms of people's acceptance of gays and gay marriage and all that, a lot of that has to do with Will and Grace. It really does. And I think when images are normalized in popular culture, that has a huge impact. And so the fact that you don't see, you know, black atheist characters, you know, people don't get an opportunity to be exposed to that and see that, okay, well, they can just be normal people.
Black music itself has historically been closely tied with the church. So how does Graydon Square feel about being an atheist in an industry that expects religiosity?
Somebody like a Graydon Square would not exist in its current state had the conditions not been what they are. I guess, for example, when I listened to Jesus Walks for the first time, all I could really hear was the beat. I just remember that beat being so dope. I didn't even care what was going on.
To the hustlers, killers, murderers, drug dealers, even the scribbles. Jesus Walks with them. To the victims of welfare, feel we living in hell here. Hell yeah. Jesus Walks with them. Now here we wanna see thee more.
And the point of me even saying that is you can't deny good music. So my idea was, hey, if Kanye can get me to like Jesus Walks from a sonic perspective, I can get people to listen to my music from a sonic perspective. You may not like what I'm saying, but you can't say that I'm whack. You can't say that I don't pick good beats. You can't say that I don't have good production quality or that I have bad engineering. You just have to say, I don't agree with what he's talking about, which says nothing about my skill level.
We took all of our collective forces and unified it. You read the Bible, and that isn't even pseudoscience. You think I'm afraid of Islam, like I'm shook nervous? I'll torture Quran with my lyrics, fuck a book burning. These blacks accept the religion of the slave master, but they wouldn't accept it if you were a gay rapper. Why is it when we want to move forward, we face backwards? Our community sick, religion the main factor. You have such a problem with gays and transsexuals. What if I told you that we were trans intellectuals?
Why separate black atheists from white atheists? Is there a difference? Sikibu Hutchinson, founder of Black Skeptics Los Angeles, poses a question to the predominantly white, male, new atheist movement that shows a difference of philosophical priorities.
What are you actually doing to redress the overarching issues
that
really institutionalize white supremacy and economic injustice in the not exceptionalist, not post-racial, and not colorblind United States?
What do black atheists want society to know about them? What can black society and society as a whole learn from knowing of their experiences?
Black people are not a monolith, that we're not all religious, and that in talking about and putting these issues in the forefront, we're not necessarily trying to attack other people's beliefs. We're just trying to add our voices to a conversation that in which it's been stifled.
Not all people of color identify with religion. There are people of color within, you know, various areas and geographic locations that are working hard to become, you know, a platform for those who identify as atheists and as, you know, black, Latino, and we just are trying to be more visible within the community to let people know that it's not about who's dominating the culture, it's about what you think of the world.
For me, If you take one thing from any of my songs and you say I learned something, I don't need anything else. You don't even have to buy my music. Pirate it. I don't care.
Well, you can if you have your own agenda and been spoon-fed religion from the placenta. Call yourself a Christian, Muslim, I know you do. Any religion, bet it's the one your parents chose for you. And any admission of your doubts to someone close to you will not be accepted, because forgiveness goes out the window when it's someone different.